Hello, my name is Joan Hegerfeld-Baker, and I am the Food Safety Specialist for SDSU Extension. Today we're going to talk about the adjusting of food, pH of food, and it's been used for hundreds of years by those that prepare and process foods. A food's pH is commonly monitored and manipulated for safety, spoilage, flavor, and fermentation processes. Since examples include yogurt, cottage cheese, tofu, pickles, relishes, sauerkraut, kimchi, wine, beer, a lot of home canned foods, and commercially processed foods. The pH scale ranges from 1 to 14. 1 is very acidic, while 14 is basic or alkali. Water has a pH of 7, which is considered neutral. Food processors care a lot about pH. The food's acidity level influences processing techniques used for many different kinds of foods that are preserved to be shelf stable. The pH of food that is preserved in a jar or can is categorized as an acid or a low acid, and in some instances, acidified. So low acid foods have a pH of 4.6 or greater and are processed using a pressure canner to kill dangerous pathogenic spores of Clostridium botulinum. The temperature needed to kill this spore is 240 degrees, much greater than the boiling temperature of water. Examples of these low acid foods are your meat, your poultry, fish products, and vegetables. Here we have some canned buffalo meat, and here is some homemade canned beef stew. And these would have to be in a pressure canner because the pH level is high, which will allow the growth of Clostridium botulinum. A boiling water bath canner is used for acid and acidified foods because these types of food products, the pH is below 4.6. The food in these types of products or in these jars when it's canned needs to reach 185 degrees Fahrenheit throughout the whole product when thermally processed. That will destroy the microorganisms of concern, including mold spores. So your acid foods, your jams, your jellies, here's some applesauce, some home canned peaches, here's some commercially canned fruit syrup. These are foods that have a pH naturally well below 4.6. Then we have our acidified foods. Here we have sauerkraut. Here, I'll move some of these out of the way, which is a fermented food product, and some bread and butter pickles and salsa. These are all examples of where an acid was either added to the food product, such as these two, or through fermentation, it became more acidic, meaning the pH lowered and it became well below 4.6. When home preserving foods, use a tested recipe so you can home can with confidence. The United States Department of Agriculture and land-grant universities such as South Dakota State University and companies that use USDA guidelines are examples of credible sources. Also visit the SDSU Extension iGrow website, igrow.org, for more information on food safety and home food preservation.